I could show you love. Wish I could make you know it. Baby, you need to know it. Where do you go every time I touch it there? Whispering love, ain't nobody gotta hear. Hey loves, welcome back to my channel. As you can see, well, it looked like I just woke up, which I did. But anyway, not like right now, but like maybe 20 minutes ago. I don't know. But excuse my makeup rag and my towel and all that extra stuff. This is not what that video is about, so focus on me. Okay. Anyways, so yesterday I did a reaction video to Queen's side of the story, but I didn't get to finish the video, and I was supposed to finish it yesterday. But, you know, people get busy and stuff like that, so I decided I'm gonna do it in the morning. So, well, it's the afternoon now, but it's 1:21. I'm gonna react like to the rest of it, and then after that, I'm gonna do another video today.
Then we spoke about doing a video. We spoke about doing a video together because we felt like it would be a good money move. For one, we already had like fan pages of people collaging our pictures together. It was crazy, man. And like, we were like, man, they really like, they people kept saying, I ship y'all. So I was thinking in my head, you know, this is great for my channel because I need to get my money up, you know? Mm-hmm. I have money.
I'm talking about the channel,
but I don't consider that to be my money because when I left, I couldn't even have half of that.
That's
like,
crazy.
He wouldn't give me half of it. And I didn't care at the point because I was just like, listen, I don't want no money or anything. I just really want to be done with this relationship, with this whole thing. Because it was draining. Like,
another thing for you guys who don't know, females leave mentally before they leave physically. So I just want y'all to know that. She already left mentally, sweetie. It was just the physical part, okay? I just want y'all to know.
For years. You know, of course I smiled on camera. We did what we did for our brand. But that shit was draining, y'all. And it was a lot, like I said, that happened behind closed doors that you guys do not know about. So, yeah, I was like, yeah, this is a money move. Maybe I come out there and, like, we do some videos. First time I went out there, I went with Ari and Vashay and some other girls. I was scared to go by myself. I know what it was like. I know, like, we had talked on the phone, but I was still scared. It was New York. I didn't want to go by myself. But I had still made plans to, you know, go see him for the first time in person. And we seen each other. We didn't do a video that time, but we did see each other. I went back home. I mean, I went back to Houston. I was living with Armand and Trey by this time. And I was working on my videos because I was just trying to get my bag up. Listen, I was trying to leave. I was trying to get my own apartment. I was going to get my apartment in Houston. Actually, I think me and Ari was talking about moving in together. When I went back to New York the second time, we chose to do our first video together. I had met his sister, Lee, who had helped me out with a situation with medicine, because I had released medicine on YouTube, which Clarence also encouraged me that I should release it on New Year's, because he was just like, you know, you should just go ahead with it, like, this is like a new beginning for you. And I was like, yeah, but I was scared because I knew once I released medicine, y'all, I could never go back. Chris. I was like, once I do this, it's done. Like, because nobody knew that Chris had cheated again. I kept that secret because I didn't want to look stupid. You know, I didn't want to look stupid all over again. Like, damn, people going to say, I told you so.
People's always going
to talk. So when people started asking, like, why aren't you doing a video for Chris no more? Like, why you at Trey Armand's house? Like, I don't want to say it because I felt stupid. I felt so dumb. Like, damn, I really stayed. I was dumb. So I made a song. I made medicine, you know? Anyway, Clanton, and he encouraged me to release it New Year's. Da-da. I released it. That happened. Somebody stole my song, put it on Apple.
That's crazy.
Get money for it. So I met Lee. Lee was a businesswoman. And she helped me out. Like, she helped me out a lot. Then we started talking business. And I was like, yo, could you go through my emails? And, you know, I don't go through my emails or anything like that. I don't know about labels. And she used to be a manager of, back in the day, of Nappy Root. So, like, she had some experience in that. It just felt so good to be there. I felt so free. I had a friend out there that, like, I really still consider him my friend. Even if I had had a crush on him or liked him, I still consider him my friend. Because we told each other literally, like, anything, like, if he was talking to another girl or texting another girl, I didn't really care. Even if I did, like him, I didn't care because we were not committed to each other. You know what I'm saying? I did not care. I wasn't, like, one of those kind of girls that try to force him, like, what are we? and be together, you know, he felt my vibe. He got to know me more. He looked at me as a different person. I wasn't the girl that he seen on the Smash and Pass challenge. He said I had a bad outfit, whatever, but whatever.
Y'all I'm dead.
The camera don't do me justice. This camera's not doing me justice. I was way better in person, just let y'all know. The people that see me in person can vouch for it. But, like, he was feeling my vibe. I could tell. I knew it. I was feeling his vibe. And we just, like, we still was keeping it, like, we still was friends, you know? Friends with feelings building. So, the situation, when I finally signed the divorce papers, with Chris after seeing him, I'm not gonna lie, I sat in the car and I cried. And Lee was right there next to me. I cried because, like, it's not that I wanted to be with him. It was also like a feeling of like, damn, 5 years down the drain, what's gonna happen next?
Damn.
Like, I know that relationship was toxic, but he's all I knew. Like, I'm really like, you know what I'm saying? I'm really going through my head like, dang. You know, but I knew for a fact I didn't want to go back because it was so unhealthy and it was so toxic. And it only broke me down the more I stayed. Physically,
it was mad sad when she posted that video after they broke up. And she was in the car crying.
And I'm sure you guys could tell by just in my personality. And when Clarence met me and seen me, it's like he brought something new out of me. And he wanted to make me feel good. I wanted to make him feel good too because from what I was told, that was a very toxic situation for him as well. You know? And I understood, man. Like, you can't just get over someone that you love for 5 years. I totally get that. But at the same time, us bonding and confiding with each other only made us kind of closer, you know? Obviously, we did things. I got pregnant. I didn't plan to get pregnant. I don't check my ovulation. I never did that.
Where, me either. I just get my shit and that's it. Go away, that's it.
The year before. Terrible miscarriage, y'all. I lost so much blood, I thought I was gonna die.
Yeah, I remember that.
I thought that something was wrong with me. I thought, like, maybe I can't have kids. And the only reason why I thought that was because even when I got pregnant with CJ, I was having unprotected sex for a very long time. And it took me a while to get pregnant. Truthfully, before CJ, I can't confirm if it was a miscarriage or not, but I remember one day feeling the pain so deep, I lost so much blood, and I don't know what it came from. I never confirmed if it was a miscarriage or not. It could have been. And then I was having unprotected sex more. I got pregnant with CJ after 2 years. Had complications with CJ. Me and CJ could have died. CJ's heart rate was going down. My heart, like, it was just like, I didn't know. So I was like, I'm scared to have kids. I had to have C-section with him. Then, in my marriage, you know, I was still doing things, and I never got pregnant. I was like, okay, maybe I just can't, I don't know, maybe just, I don't know. Then I got pregnant. I had a miscarriage. Okay, so I'm thinking in my head, maybe, like, my body's just rejecting kids. Like, maybe CJ was just my miracle baby. You know what I'm saying? And the crazy thing is, when I had that miscarriage, bro, something in me told me it just wasn't meant. It just wasn't meant. It's so crazy because I don't even, I seen a video of, like, last year, I seen a video of me saying something about the name Legend. I've seen a Facebook post of me saying, man, I just keep seeing the name Legend everywhere. And I was like, whoa, this is crazy. It's like, I was like manifesting, or I was just like, I've seen signs. I lost the baby, but I was still seeing the name Legend everywhere. It was so weird, you guys.
Damn, this is one long video.
And then fast forward, I meet Clarence, and I get pregnant. I did not think I was going to get pregnant. Truthfully, I didn't think Clarence was telling me he thought his soldiers didn't march. He thought they didn't march because he had never had a pregnancy scare with any girl. So on my end, I'm like, okay, well, shoot, we fine. I think we slipped up one time. I never got pregnant. So I was like, oh, okay. That was our business, though. We wasn't going to tell nobody that. Like, read into it and seen it. But by that time, Clarence was a single man. We were not committed to each other. We still had a very close friendship, but just doing grown. I don't know what happened on the other side of that, but all I know is, like, I was very understanding. I never planned anything out. I never maliciously moved or tried to take someone's family away or, you know, I never did that. Like, I'm not that kind of girl. I'm not that kind of person because, like I said, I know how it feels. I never did anything to her. I would never do anything just to hurt another woman. If anything, I was just going off of what I felt. I couldn't help my feelings. And me and Clarence, I think we told a story on how, like, we first told each other we loved each other. It was crazy because, like, he even felt crazy saying it because he was just like, man, this is so crazy. I was just in a whole 5-year relationship, but it feels like I've known you, so long, you know? Like, it feels like, I don't know why I feel like I love you, like, and I felt the same. I was like, Clarence, I feel like I love you, too. It just happened. Nobody even meant for that to happen. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm pretty sure, though, like, when you keep hanging with people, like...
It came natural, that's it.
Truth be told, I thought we were going to do our video, do some more videos, get a bag. I thought it was going to be business, too, you know? And then kind of, like, fade away. That's what I really thought, but it turned out to be different. Thinking about his ex. I wasn't even thinking about... You know what I'm saying? Like, I didn't know her. All I could think about was the relationship that me and him was building. We was always very honest with each other, too. We still, to this day, are very honest with each other about our past and how we feel about certain things. Like, we just got that kind of relationship. Like, we're friends, too, till this day. We're still friends. Anything that was said before, I don't know, by his mom or whatever, she didn't know me. So I get it. I completely get it. She didn't know me at all. And I was this new girl coming in. I had a kid already. She probably like, yo, who is this lady coming in? You know what I'm saying? And she already knew his ex for 5 years. So they probably had a relationship. And I understand that. You know, that's completely normal. I get that. But as she got to know me more, the kind of girl that I was, her love grew for me as well. She loves me now. She loves me. She loves me and she loves both of my kids. And she always tells me how appreciative she is of me, how I love her son, the way I love her son. She's thankful. I try to be as easygoing as possible with Clarence. I can deal with him. I can handle him. I know what kind of man he is. He's a great man. But I know how to deal with Clarence. I know how to deal with him, and I don't know, I get him, you know? He gets me. That's my side. I feel better because I got the clear, I don't know, my name. I don't know, shit. Like, maybe people won't even believe it. Truly, I don't care what you guys are saying because I know my heart, you know what I'm saying? And me and Clarence, I feel like our relationship speaks for itself. We're very genuine. It was genuine. It was nothing. Maybe it started off something different, but it ended up something different, and that's just life, and that just happened. And sometimes you can't help it. And truthfully, who knows? Maybe, like, even if me and Clarence don't even end up together forever, things happen. Things happen. Like,
don't even speak that into existence.
It was never to hurt nobody, bro. It was never to take anything away from anyone. I'm all for women. Like, I make women empowerment songs. Like, I make songs about stuff. So the fact that people are saying, oh, you a homewrecker, and how could you do that when you went through the same thing? Y'all just gotta understand the place that I was in from my point of view. I wasn't going through her. Like, I'm not her. She's not me. We had a different view of life at the time. But I'm a very genuine person, bro. Like, I don't have nothing against nobody. I don't have nothing against nobody at all. We're happy. We have a son together. I don't want him to grow up and see certain things. I don't even want CJ to grow up and see certain things. But I know he's already starting to read. I'm going to have to explain to him one day. And if Legend sees everything else, you know, we're going to have to explain it to him. I don't want them to think of
Mm-hmm. People be talking and don't even know like what happened, like the real story. That's why you gotta get everybody's side of the story. They just like, oh, you're a homewrecker. Like, no. Anyways, this is the end of my video. I don't want it to be too long. It's already 17 minutes long, but I'm gonna try to trim it a little bit. Parts I don't need, you know, because I know y'all don't want to see it and just be like mad bored. So anyway, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And I'm gonna do another video later on today. I'm gonna shower, get my day started, blah, blah, blah. I might go to Starbucks or something, I don't know. My favorite place. And then I'm gonna do my video later, so I'm gonna holla at y'all.
I'm killing it when I'm feeling it, kissing it and turning to an animal. Yeah, yeah, girl, I fuck with a attitude.